Good morning, children. Today we will start with fruits and seeds. Okay, this will be your last topic in the post-fertilization changes. By then, the lesson is getting over. Okay, so seeds and fruits. So we know about. See, I have drawn the diagram. So this is a false fruit. Apple is a false fruit, isn't it? So false fruit diagram is here, and this is the structure of seed. This is a structure of a seed, monopod seed. Structure of monopod seed. So let me write the description part here. So seeds. What are called as seeds? Seeds are nothing but it is a fertilized ovule, isn't it? So seeds. Seeds, but in other area we can say. So seeds are available. It is a fertilized ovule. It is a fertilized ovule. So ovule. After the fertilization, it becomes seeds. Fertilized ovule are called as seeds. Then, the second point about the seeds are, it is the last stage. Seed formation is the last stage of fertilization process. I mean, post-fertilization process. Post-fertilization process. Post-fertilization process. And this seeds, the ovule, or the seed. After the fertilization, the ovule changes to the seeds, isn't it? The seeds are present inside the ovary. It is present inside the ovary. So the ovary is nothing but after the fertilization it becomes fruit, isn't it? The ovary will be getting converted into fruit. So ovule to seed and the ovary to fruit. So ovule is present inside the ovary, so seed is present inside the fruit. Isn't it? Next, what are the parts in seeds? It has cotyledons. Then second one, it has an integuments. Then third one, it has an embryo. Now coming to the first one, that is cotyledons. The first one is what? Cotyledons. The cotyledons will take, it is a simple structure. So cotyledons are simple structure. How the cotyledons will resemble? The cotyledons will be thick and swollen. And this cotyledons will act as a reserve food material. So it stores the food materials, and this cotyledons will give the nourishments for the developing saplings, the seedlings we are telling now. So it's a reserve food materials which gives the nourishments, to the developing seedlings. And in case of dicots, there are two cotyledons. Whereas in case of monopods, monocotyledon varieties, it has one cotyledon. It has only one cotyledon. That cotyledon we are calling it as what? Scutellum. This is about the cotyledons. Next to what we have is the integuments. Second one is integuments, isn't it? Now coming to the second point is integuments. This integuments and the integuments are getting converted into seed pod. After the fertilization process of the integuments, we can write it, I can write it as the seed pod. So integuments. There are two seed coats. One is the outer seed coat and inner seed coat. Outer integument and inner integuments. This outer integuments, when you take, it is called as testa. And the inner integuments are called as tegmen. It is called as what? Tegmen. Testa and tegmen. And this seed coat will be odd. And main function is it gives protection. It gives what? Protection. And this integuments will have a celebrate. The integuments will take, the integuments will be having a pore. It will be having what? It will be having a pore. That pore is called as a micropylar region. Through this pore only, oxygen and water required for the seed to germination will be passed. So required for the seed to undergo germination will be getting passed. Final pore. So above the micropyle there is a region which is called as hyllus. The main function of the hyllus is helps in the attachment of seeds towards the fruit. Because we know very well the seeds are present inside the ovary, isn't it? If I say for example ovule structure, we know very well how the ovule will be like this, isn't it? So ovule will be getting surrounded by two wall layers, and this is called as ovary, and inside the ovary the ovule will be present. So now this ovary will be getting attached towards the ovule like this. It will be getting attached, and this particular region is called as the hyllus. Is called as what? Hyllus. So seeds for the array, it will not be present just like that inside the ovary, isn't it? Inside the fruit the seed will be getting attached, because from the ovary the nourishment which is needed for the seed has to be passed through the placenta, we are telling, isn't it? So that the placenta we are getting converted into hyllus after the post fertilization changes. So we are calling it as a hyllus. So micropyle of the pore, hyllus of the adrenalium, and the seeds fully there is a pore, and the integuments there is a pore. That is about the integuments. And next to the integuments, what we have is an embryo. Next one is an embryo. What embryo we have studied, isn't it? This embryo will undergo various developmental stages, and as a result will give rise to the formation of epicotyle and hypocotyle. Now next one about the seed is, next point is about the endosperm. Next one is what? About the endosperm. So now about the endosperm. Endosperm is nothing but, it is a nutritive tissue for the embryo, for the developing embryo. In some plants, this endosperm will be completely taken, isn't it? There will not be any residual endosperm left inside the seed. Then such a type of endosperms are called as no residual. Then we are calling it as non-endospermous seed, or otherwise ex-albuminous or non-albuminous seeds. So what is the meaning? If no residual endosperms are present, no residual endosperm or present, then we are calling it as ex-albuminous seeds, or non-albuminous seeds, or non-endospermous seeds. Okay, so example we can say all varieties of grams and beans are the examples. There are endospermous seeds. What is meant by endospermous seeds? The endospermous seeds are, the residual endosperms will be left inside the embryo. Residual endosperm left within the seed. Then they are called as an endospermous seeds. Example is Ricinus communis, which is a castor plant, isn't it? Ricinus communis, by no name, U4BAC, it belongs to the family U4BAC, common name is castor. Okay, we know one term already. பெரிஸ்பர்ம் சீட்ஸே பெரிஸ்பர்ம் ஒரு டேர்ம் இருக்கு there are பெரிஸ்பர்ம் சீட்ஸ் பெரிஸ்பர்ம் பெரிஸ்பர்ம் சீட்ஸ் அப்படினா என்ன அர்த்தம்னா we know nucellus what are called as nucellus nucellus are nothing but the nutritive tissue which is present inside the ovule that is inside the embryo sac and it is meant for the developing egg cells developing polar nuclei for the antipodals ke time and nourishments ella derive panikite irukum ena it should be matured enough no maturity reach pannanum adula chromosome number wire la vechitte irukanum so for that it needs a nourishment and provide pannakudiyathu the new cells sometimes in certain seeds like pepper like black pepper example very small example is black pepper similarly beet varieties of plants are introduced part of the path there will be the nucellus which is remnant in nature remnant nucellus nucella tissue abin solluvom nucella tissue or nucella cells will be present inside the seed then we are calling it as a perispermous seeds or otherwise it is called as a perisperm seeds okay then one more topic about the seeds left out irukku adha let me write it here see for example I told you microphylla ena present aayirukku hole is there seed la microphylla is there that's a hole and the hole valiya what is getting passed oxygen and water molecules are getting passed nu solrom if the oxygen and water molecules pass pananum for the germination to take place okay the seeds patena it becomes dry eppa idu dry aagum when the embryo develops embryo develop aaga the seeds will become dry seeds will become dry seed dry aayichu appadina then that period is called as a dormant period dormancy the seed is under a period of dormancy appa when the favorable condition comes on return of a favorable condition adukku nalla condition favorable ana or condition vanda odane what will happen if the favorable condition comes then the seeds will imbibe the water molecule then it becomes bigger and bigger because the volume will get increased because of imbibition the turgid pressure will be there out of which the seed coat will get ruptures and the cotyledons will come out and the radicals and the globules will go epicotyl and the hypocotyl will start to grow that is the phenomenon isn't it so appa dormancy period indrathu seeds ku mattum irukku appdi solrom indha dormancy period evlo verikku dormant ah or seed ala maximum irukka mudiyuna for a period of 10000 years verikku or seed ala adu rotten aagama growing aagama the seed dormant ah 10000 years verikku irukka mudiyum for example the binomial lupinus Arcticus, which is present in the tundra region, Arctic tundra region is a plant which belongs to the legume family. It belongs to leguminosae. So that is legume family belongs to what? Legume family. Very very important. And this plant can survive for more than the plant of the seed can be dormant for a period of 10,000 years. இப்ப நியூவா ஒரு பிளான்ட் ஸ்பீஷஸ் ஐடென்டிஃபை பண்ணிருக்காங்க ஃபீனிக்ஸ் கேட்டலிஃபெரா அப்படினு சொல்லக்கூடிய அந்த ஸ்பீஷஸ் அந்த ரைட்டிங் ஹியர் ஃபீனிக்ஸ் கேட்டலிஃபெரா ஃபீனிக்ஸ் கேட்டலிஃபெரா which belongs to the family Aricaceae the palm plants are mentioned dates டேட் பாம் ஆமட்டில டேட் பாம் அப்படினு சொல்றோம் இந்த பிளான்ட் வந்து 2000 இயர்ஸ் வரைக்கும் அதோட சீட்ஸ் வந்து வயர்லா 2000 இயர்ஸ் வரைக்கும் அந்த சீட்ஸ் வந்து வயர்லா இது எப்படி எப்ப கண்டுபிடிச்சாங்க அப்படினு பார்த்தா டியூ பை தி ஆர்க்கியோலாஜிக்கல் எக்ஸ்கவேஷன் பை an archaeological excavation process excavation ல தே ஃபைண்ட் ஆர்க்கியோலாஜிக்கல் ரிப்போர்ட் கொடுத்திருக்கு தட் இஸ் a proven and true record so adre in the phoenix dactylifera which belongs to the family Aricaceae in the Aricaceae family sarna the phoenix dactylifera the seed is remaining dormant without getting spoiled and even after 2000 years when it gets a favorable condition then that seed can undergo germination and can give rise to the formation of radicals and the plumule it has been proven scientifically okay? And this seal remains dormant for 2000 years, according to the archaeological report is telling. Can you understand? So these are the points that you have to study in seals. Again, I will explain you from the beginning. And then again, I will tell you continuity actually. Now you see the seeds. What is the first point? Seeds are the fertilized ovule. So ovule, after the fertilization, it becomes a seed. So once the seed is getting formed, then we can say the fertilization process is getting over. The post-fertilization process has also got over. Now later we can say, so therefore it's the last stage of the post-fertilization. Then the ovule will be getting converted into seed, and this seed will be present inside the fruit. The fruit are getting formed from the ovary. And the ovule, fertilization of the seed, the ovary is getting converted into a fruit, isn't it? And when you take a seed, there are various parts, like it has a cotyledons, it has an integument, which we are calling as a seed coat. Embryo is present, and the fourth one is endosperm is also present. Fourth point is endosperm. Now when you take this cotyledons, the cotyledons are a simple structure, and it is very thick and it is swollen, and it has a reserve food material, storehouse of reserve food materials. Why the food materials has to be stored in the cotyledons? Because it gives the nourishment to the developing seedling. From the seed only the seedlings will come. Now the radicals will come out and the plumule will come out, the cotyledons will break open from the seed coat. All these process will take place, which we are calling as germination. So, upon the seedlings, the cotyledons, and the plumule radical greenish, the cells are rapid and multiply, mitotic divisions are going on. Upon the metabolism is taking place, and the metabolism, the growth, the division, cell division, somatic division, cell are under the care, it needs a reserve for materials. That reserve for materials are being provided by this cotyledons. That is why it is thick and then swollen, fleshy. Then when you take the dicots, there will be two cotyledons. When we take monopod varieties, the monopods will be having only one cotyledon. That cotyledon we are calling the scutellum. Last class we have studied embryology. The scutellum will be present. How scutellum will be? It is papery and feathery, which is storehouse of the reserve food materials. Okay. Next one, what we have is an integument. Integuments, it is a seed coat. There are two seed coat, two integuments. After the fertilization is getting changed, getting over, then the integuments are getting converted into the seed coat. Then between the seed coat, it is outer and inner seed coat. Outer seed coat we are calling it as testa, and inner seed coat is called as the chickmen. When you take the seed coat, it will be hot and it gives protection to the cotyledons, to the embryo, to the endosperm. So the integuments are the main function is to prevent, to give the protection, to give the protection against desiccation, environmental factors, predators, prey, whatsoever it is, there is no protection to the predator, we are calling this integuments. Next one is embryo. Already we have studied embryo, divisions, embryo will give rise to the formation of hypocotyl and epicotyl. In case of dicots, in case of monopod varieties, the polyoptyl and polyrhiza formation. So leaf primordium, root primordium, other than the radical plumule, root cap, root tip, everything will be getting formed from polyrhiza, polyoptyle, the plumule part will be getting developed. Embryo. Then endosperm, it is a nutritive tissue. And the endosperm, it is getting formed after the double fertilization, triple fusion, the endosperm, triplet nature, triploid condition. The main function is giving the nourishment from the stage of development to when it is getting developed, completely getting developed into embryo. So, in the zygote, the embryo will develop, there are various morphological changes happening, various divisions, transverse division, vertical division, periclinal divisions, finally it comes to a stage of embryo, pro-embryonal stage, and the embryonal stage. So, up low stages, the zygote are in need of the nutrients and the nourishment. Those nourishments and the nutrients are needed for the zygote to undergo various morphological changes will be given only by the endosperm. So endosperm is very, very important. Suppose if the endosperm is completely utilized by the seed, so if it is being completely utilized by the embryo, and if there is no endosperm is present inside the seed, then we are calling it as eggs albuminous or non-albuminous or non-endospermous. For example, gram varieties, beans, and we can take it as an example. Endospermous seeds are present. Endospermous seeds are See, the residual part of endosperm, even after being utilized by the embryo, the residual part of the endosperm will remain as such inside the seed. Then we are calling it as what? Endospermous seeds. Example for that endospermous seeds are castor. Castor is almond. Almond is castor oil. We are telling no castor. Castor belonging to the family called as what? Euphorbiaceae. The binomial is all the binomial name. The binomial name is what? Ricinus communis. It belongs to the family Euphorbiaceae. Ricinus communis. Binomial name is Ricinus and Ricinus communis. Endospermous. Next, perisperm seeds. Perisperm seeds na enna appadina, see, there is a mucellous tissue. Mucellous appadina or tissue present a irukku. Embryo sac kulla. In the mucellous, nutritive in nature na. It gives a nourishment. Yaarukku the nourishments kudukku appadina, it gives nourishments to the antipodal cells, then synergic cells, egg cells, and polar nuclei. The 8 nucleus is present. 7 cell is present inside the embryo sac. And the embryo sac is the nourishments along the mucellus. Residual part of the mucellus, other remnant mucellus of the mucellar tissue of its sonoria, and the mucellar tissue will be present inside the embryo sac, will be carried out to the seed, the residual part of the embryo sac. Remnant endosperm, remnant mucellar tissues of embryo that will be retained as such inside the seed, which will be utilized by the cotyledons, will be utilized by the radicals and the primule. And the mucellar tissue of the irundadana, such a type of seeds we are calling as a perisperm. Example is black pepper is a very example, the best example for the perisperm. Next one, I am going to show you seeds, patina, seeds, and the seed coat. When you take, and the embryo the develop agar seed enna seiyum undergoes a process of dehydration and with the water molecules ella adhu adu kuduthu 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 nalla shrink aayirum it gets shrunken appdi solrom nalla vera shrink aayirum what it lost its water molecules kuduthu kuduthu nalla shrunk aayi or dormant rest period rest phase appdi solrom absence of metabolism endha metabolism adu nadakkama irukkudiye or dormant period and the dormant period the water molecules ellathiyum liberate panna peragu it gets shrunken and it loses its water molecule it will be under a stage phase of arrest and dormancy appdi solrom or seed anadhu evlo period varaikum dormant ah irukka mudiyum spoil aagama ruin aagama rotten aagama irukka mudiyum appadina maximum 10,000 years varaikum or seed anadhu can maintain its viability. It can remain in a dormant period, dormant state, and the dormant state irundhalum kuda adu viability maintain panna mudiyum. An example is lupinus. An example edirken the lupinus orchidus appdi solakudiya plant which belongs to the family legume varieties, legume family appdi solrom adu 10,000 years varaikum adudaiya tundra region, arctic tundra region la kadaikapadiya or plant, beautiful ornamental plant, nalla violet color la flowers kudukuriyadu. You can see it in the net also. So, avlo alagana or malar, beautiful or flower appdi solakudiyadu. So, adu enna seiyum romba varshathukku and the seed vandu dormant condition la vechukuriya 10 years varaikum. Adhe mari Phoenix dactylifera appdi solakudiya or plant irukku. Dactylifera appdi solakudiya or plant irukkum, which is a date palm appdi solrom. Arikesi kaviya jarundhu. It can maintain the seed to be under a dormant state for a period of 2 years. 2 வருஷம் வரைக்கும் அந்த கார்மெண்ட் கண்டிஷன்லயே தன்னுடைய சீடை வயபிளா வச்சிருக்கக்கூடிய டெண்டன்சி யாருக்கு இருக்கு ஃபீனிக்ஸ் டாக்டிலிஃபெராக்கு இருக்கு சோ அந்த ஃபீனிக்ஸ் டாக்டிலிஃபெரா கேன் மெயின்டெயின் ஃபார் அ பீரியட் ஆஃப் 2 இயர்ஸ் அதோட சீடை வந்து டார்மெண்ட் ஸ்டேஜ்லயே ரூயினாக ராட்டனாக வச்சுக்க முடியும் பிலாங்கிங் டு த ஃபேமிலி அரிகேசி அண்ட் இட் ஹஸ் பீன் டிஸ்கவர்ட் நவ் இவ்வளோ வருஷம் அது வந்து கார்மெண்டா இருக்க முடியும் லேட்டஸ்ட் பீரியட்ல டெக்னாலஜிக்கல் அட்வான்ஸ் அதை ஐடென்டிஃபை பண்ணியிருக்காங்க பை தி ஆர்கியாலஜிஸ்ட் குரூப் ஆஃப் ஆர்கியாலஜிஸ்ட் பை ஆர்கியாலஜிக்கல் எஸ்டிமேஷன் ப்ராசஸ் சோ இவ்ளோ பாயிண்ட்ஸ் நம்ம எதுக்கு எழுதுறோம் சீட்ஸ் எழுதுறோம் இதுல சீட்ஸ் நிறைய நான் ஒரு மோனோபாட் சீட் ஒரு சாம்பிள் பார்த்து நான் டிரா பண்ணிருக்கேன் பாரு இது அவுட்டர் லேயர் அப்படி சொல்றோம் இல்லையா டூ அவுட்டர் லேயர் பார்த்தோமே எழுதிடலாம் வி கேன் கால் இட் அஸ் எ சீட் கோட் இல்லையா அவுட்டர் மோஸ்ட் லேயர் அவுட்டர் சீட் கோட் இன்னர் சீட் கோட் இன்டெக்மென்ட்ஸ் அவுட்டர் இன்டெக்மென்ட் இன்னர் இன்டெக்மென்ட் டெஸ்ட் அப்படி சொல்றோம் அவுட்டர் இன்னர் என்னன்னு சொல்றோம் டெக்மென்ட் அப்படி சொல்றோம் புக்ல குடுக்கல என்ன சொல்றோம் எல்லாமே லேபிள் பண்ணுவோம் டெஸ்டா நான் எல்லாமே எழுதி போடுறோம் இல்லையா டெஸ்டா அதுவும் இஸ் கால்ட் இஸ் வாட் டேக்மென்ட் சோ டெஸ்டா இருக்கு டேக்மென்ட் இஸ் பிரசன்ட் அது அடுத்து இருக்கக்கூடியது பேருனா எண்டோஸ்பெர்ம் அப்படினு சொல்றோம் தி எண்டோஸ்பெர்ம் will be present அது அடுத்து இருக்கக்கூடியது we are calling it as a cotyledons will be present அந்த cotyledons க்கு கீழே இருக்கக்கூடியது we call it as a hypocotyl and this region is called a root length binomial na form aagum radical form aaga aarambichirum idu ellame epicotyl region appdi nam solluvoliya epicotyl region la indre give rise to formation appdi shoot apex ellame form aaga aarambichirum okay so this region is called as the hypocotyl so this structure you have to draw at least for the seed the seed pathi ketta idu ella technical terms ella eludrom example binomial name enna binomial name kuduthukom and the binomial name kuduthukom and then finally what diagram you have to draw for the seed okay appo seed la integuments eludrom outer integument testa inner integument integument eludrom adukku adutha varakudaiya endosperm endosperm kuda cotyledons cotyledons appo hypocotyl epicotyl hypocotyl la irundhu varakudaiya radical and radical varanum radical la root cap root tip label pannanum adhe maari similarly here epicotyl and epicotyl la irukkudaiya pluvial part that is shoot apex you have to label it
fruits fruits the fertilized ovary the ovary after the fertilization then we are calling it as a fruit the fruit has the wall layers that wall layer is called as pericarp that pericarp has three wall layers again nam adha library la padipom epicarp mesocarp and endocarp then such a type of fruits another such type of fruits ovary irundhu fruit vanda inge ellai pole such type of fruits such fruits are called as true fruits what are called as true fruits the fruits which are developed from the ovary then we are calling it as a true fruits appdi solluvom second type of fruits are there that fruits are called as either true fruits or type next type of fruits we are calling as false fruits next one what we are calling as the false fruits appadina the ovary will not give rise to the formation of edible portion that is a fruit adhu badal the thalamus will be ipo idu vandu false fruit paarenga inga seeds ella present a irukku ullukulla idu endocarp nu solrom inga region la nam mesocarp nu solrom epicarp region la present a irukku ana inga fully edible portion nam enna solrom idu da nam consume pandrom this portion we are not having it in the apple illaya can you understand so this region actually idu da ovary ovule idu da nam edible part nam consume pannanum ana nam adha saapradhu illa we are taking only other part apart from the ovule and the ovary so that part is called as the thalamus the region da nam enna solrom thalamus appo thalamus da nam food ah saapidrom so andha mari category ana plant da nam enna solrom false fruits appo what is meant by false fruits false fruits appadina the thalamus will be the edible portion the thalamus will be the edible part which is consumable we are called as the false fruits next to the false fruits another fruit is one of the type liya other one is called as orthocarpic fruits idu ella question paper la kekkirpaanga orthocarpic fruits what is meant by orthocarpic fruits or fruit form aagum appadina fertilization nadakkum fertilization enna artham fusion of male gamete and female gamete fertilization nadandhu or fertilized product da nama fruit nu solrom ana there are certain kinds of plants where the fertilization will not take place fertilization e nadakkama or fruit kudukapudiya certain category plants are there such type of fruits are called as orthocarpic fruits so what are orthocarpic fruits the development of fruits takes place without the act of fertilization so orthocarpic fruits na the fruit oda development nadakkum without fertilization exception cases idella seedless fruits appdi solrom seedless grapes ipo hybrid varieties na varudhu fertilization nadakkadilla illaya so without the act of guava without the act of fertilization of fruit kudukka mudiyum pineapple enga the seed kandupidikkave mudiyadhu so what is meant by orthocarpic fruits andha mari orthocarpic fruits ellame necessary to be seedless in nature appdi solvanga the seed illame irukum ஏனா அதுல オリジナルலாம் என்ன இல்ல ஃபர்டிலைசேஷன் ஹஸ்ன்ட் டேக் ஸ்பேஸ் So the fruit, the development of the fruit takes place without the act of fertilization. Then such type of fruits are called as the parthenopalpic fruits. So how many varieties of fruits we have? We have two fruits, ovary fruit and the fruit fruit and so on. Nangicara indica is a very best example for that. Mango, false fruits, one another. Apple is a very best example where the thalamus is getting converted into a fruit. The ovary is not an edible part. The thalamus has become an edible part that is consumable. So the thalamus we are considering it as a fruit. Therefore, such type of fruits are called as the false fruits. Parthenopalpic fruits, those fruits, these fruits are getting formed without the act of fertilization. These fruits are necessarily to be seedless in nature. That is called as parthenopalpic fruits. Okay, so this is about fruits. ஒரு எக்ஸெல் அந்த எக்ஸெல் என்ன ஆகணும் ஃபர்டிலைசேஷன் நடக்கணும் அந்த எக்ஸெல் ஆனது ஃபர்டிலைசேஷன் குள்ளேயும் போகாது அந்த எக்ஸெல் ஆனது ரிடக்ஷன் டிவிஷன் குள்ளேயும் வராது அந்த எக்ஸெல் டைரக்டாகவே எம்பிரியோவாக கன்வெர்ட் ஆகும் ஸோ அப்போ நெசசரிலி அங்கே என்னென்ன நடந்திருக்கு ஏ செக்ஷுவல் ஃபினோமினல் தான் செக்ஷுவல் ப்ராசஸ் அங்கே நடக்கவே இல்லை ஃபியூஷன் நடக்கவே இல்லை ஃபர்டிலைசேஷன் நடக்கவே இல்லை என்ன சொல்கிறேன் நான் ஒரு எக்ஸெல் யூ நோ எக்ஸெல் The cell will not undergo. Bookla pata puriya la mari irukum shorta elikkrada puriyum. Will not undergo fertilization. Fertilization kula mattum dhaan povada nu paatha illa. It will not undergo the reduction division irukkar. So it will not undergo the reduction division like meiosis. That is called as meiosis. அப்போ meiosis ஓ நடக்குது fertilization ஓ நடக்குது ஆனா அந்த egg cell என்ன செய்யணும் டைரக்டா develop into an embryo. Develops into an embryo. Then we are calling it as apomixis. அப்போ என்ன இதோட concept என்னது only asexual process is happening. The sexual process has been minimized. Then it is called as apomixis. அப்போ apomixis தான் என்ன ஒரு புரிஞ்சுக்கணும். What are apomixis? Apomixis அப்படின்னா ஒரு எக்ஸெல் fertilization குள்ளேயும் போகாது reduction division குள்ளேயும் போகாது ஆனால் அது டைரக்டா டெவலப் செய்யறது எப்படியோ that means only asexual process is taking place no sexual process so sexual process has been minimized then we are calling it as what apomixis அப்படின்னு சொல்றோம் இது வெரி பெஸ்ட் எக்ஸாம்பிள் இஸ் ஆஸ்ட்ரேசி ஃபேமிலி ஆஸ்ட்ரேசி சன்ஃப்ளவர் பிளான்ட் பார்த்தோம் இல்லையா ஹீலியர்டர் சாண்டஸ் சூரியகாந்தி குடும்பம் சன்ஃப்ளவர் ஃபேமிலி எல்லாமே calling it as ஆஸ்ட்ரேசி Asteraceae. So the plants belong to Asteraceae, beautiful flowers from the dicot variety, ages for the plant is Asteraceae. So Asteraceae, and you can take grass as an example for this. You can take what? Grass. Grass is the belongs to the family Poaceae, Graminate varieties. Okay, grass, Asteraceae. Asteraceae the types that you can take Helianthus anus. So Helianthus anus, which is called as sunflower plant, oil extract, oil seed, oil we are extracting. So Helianthus anus, this is called as what? Apomixis. So apomixis na enna edirala. Next kadasiya irukkudhu polyembryony appdinu solrom. That is that they are calling it as polyembryony. So, body embryo termly is another many embryos are getting formed. Many embryos will be getting formed. Yeah, polyembryonal stage. Okay, so the polyembryony, many mini embryo will be getting formed. See, poly embryo. இதுக்கு என்னன்னா நியூசெலஸ் டிஷ்யூ இருக்கும். எதுல இருக்கு நியூசெலஸ்? நியூசெலஸ் will be present inside embryo sac. கரெக்ட்டா? நியூசெலஸ் will be present inside the embryo sac. இந்த நியூசெலஸ் என்ன பண்ணா? இட் டிவைட்ஸ். இட் gets divided. இது டிவைட் ஆயிட்டு the divided நியூசெலஸ் enters into into the new cells will be there, the embryo sac will divide and each will divide and gets enter into that of the embryo sac and egg cells la engala irukko and the embryo sac la irukkuye egg cells irukkuye region ellame appadi appadi spread aayidhu. This spread aayidhu and the each divided new cells will get converted into an embryo. What is polyembryo? The new cells are the new cells tissue and then are divided up and the new cells number repeated are divided. It just goes in between, it occupies space wherever the egg cells or the synergid cells are eduthukalam poittu it itself directly getting converted into an embryo again without the act of fertilization. And the stage that I am mentioning now, we are calling it as polyembryonic stage. So what is the polyembryonic stage? The fertilization process is done there, and the new cell tissues matto enna idu irukke, new cell tissues matto rapid ah divide aagite irukke, and the new cell tissue rapid ah divide aagite adu engella cells irukko and the cells ella poite it give rise to the formation of mini embryos. Example for the polyembryonic stage enna paathina citrus varieties. Example is citrus example enna adu lemon illa citrus plant ke example citrus and the rutaceae it belongs to the family is what rutaceae varieties Mangosteinica adapaceae Mangosteinica it belongs to the family adapaceae yeah? So and the plant ellame நடக்குது அந்த சந்ததிகள்ல இருந்து இன்னொரு ஆஃப் ஸ்பிரிங் ப்ரோஜெனி வரணும். நெக்ஸ்ட் ஜெனரேஷன் ஷட் கண்டினியூ. அத கண்டினியூ ஆகுறதுக்கு ஹெல்ப் பண்ணக்கூடியது சீட் தான். ஏனா சீட் ஜெர்மினேட் ஆகலனா ஒரு பிளான்ட் க்ரோ ஆகவே முடியாது. ஃப்ரூட் இருந்திருக்கலாம், மத்த எந்த பார்ட் வேணா இருந்துட்டே இருக்கலாம். ஆனா அந்த சீட் இஸ் வெரி வெரி ஃபிளார் இருக்கலாம், ஸ்டெம் இருக்கலாம், ரூட் இருக்கலாம், லீவ்ஸ் இருக்கலாம், வாட்ஸ் எவரே சீட் எதுவுமே என்ன பண்ண முடியாது, இன்னொரு ஒரு பிளான்ட் கொண்டாரவே முடியாது. ஆனா இன்னொரு ஒரு பிளான்ட் ஸ்பீஷியஸே உருவாக்க முடியும் அப்படின்னு சொன்னா, ஜெனெட்டிக்கலா கொண்டு வர முடியும் அப்படின்னு சொன்னா, ஐடென்டிக்கலா கொண்டு வர முடியும் அப்படின்னா, தட் இஸ் பிகாஸ் ஆஃப் பை மீன்ஸ் ஆஃப் த சீட். சீட் தான் ஜெனரேட் ஆகிட்டு அந்த ஆஃப் ஸ்பிரிங்கோ இல்லை ப்ரோஜெனியோ அது கொண்டு வர முடியும், ரேடிக்கல் ப்ரோஜெனியோ அது கொண்டு வர முடியும். இது அதனால தான் சீடு வந்து ஒரு ப்ராமினன்ட் ஸ்ட்ரக்சர் ஆஃப் அ ஃபர்டிலைஸ்டு ப்ராடக்ட்னு சொல்கிறோம். அது போக அதுக்கு நிறைய அடாப்டிவ் ஃபீச்சர்ஸ்லாம் உண்டு. என்னென்ன அடாப்டிவ் ஃபீச்சர்ஸ்லாம் இந்த சீட்ஸ் இருக்குன்னு பார்த்தோன்னா, அது வந்து டிஸ்பர்சல் மெக்கானிசத்துக்கு இருக்கக்கூடிய ஒரு டெண்டன்சி. இந்த சீடு ஃபார்ம் ஆகணும்னா பாலினேஷன் நடக்கணும், ஃபர்டிலைசேஷன் ஷுட் டேக்ஸ் பிளேஸ். So in order to take the pollination and the fertilization, the water is not an essential medium for the pollination and the fertilization. That is also one of the very very prominent feature for the development of the seed. Second, and the dispersal, wherever it wants it can get dispersed and it can germinate and it can appear under the progeny and the species for the endangered extinct ஆகாம எந்த பர்டிகுலர் ரீஜன் வேணா போயிட்டு அந்த சூழ்நிலைக்கு தகுந்த மாதிரி அந்த பிளான்ட் என்ன பண்ணி வச்சிருக்கு, அடாப்ட் பண்ணி வச்சிருக்கு. அடாப்டிவ் ஃபீச்சர்ஸ் அது கிடைச்சது. அதே மாதிரி இந்த சீடால என்ன பண்ண முடியும், அன்ஃபேவரபிள் சர்க்கம்ஸ்டான்சஸ் கண்டிஷன்ஸ் இல்ல, கண்டியூசிவான அதுக்கு என்வாயர்மெண்ட் சன்லைட் இல்ல, ஹியூமிடிட்டி இல்ல, மாய்ஸ்சர் இல்ல, வாட்டர் வேப்பர் இல்ல, சாயில் இருக்கு மினரல் நியூட்ரியன்ஸ் அந்த pH ரேஞ்ச் இது எதுவுமே அதுக்கு ஃபேவரபலா இல்லனா, இட் ரிமைன்ஸ் அண்டர் பீரியட் ஆஃப் டார்மன்சி. unless and until a favorable condition comes, it remains under a phase of dormancy. So favorable condition vanda odana it undergoes the bivision, imbibition, target pressure, same code ruptures and the germination will starts to take place. Idha enna innum solrom, the adaptive features, very very important prominent features of the seeds. So that's why the seed can undergo germination, give rise to the formation of a new generation, new progeny or the new offspring, new plant body, new seedlings, new saplings are made. So ipa seeds pathi padichirukom, fruits pathi padichom, nariya perisperm seed na enna appa suppose ketanga you have to answer what is meant by a perisperm seed. A perisperm seed appadina the new cell is completely exist agama remnant form of the new cell will remains as a remnant new cell appadi nam solrom. Residual part of the new cells will remain as such, which will be carried inside the seed. Such type of seeds we are calling it as a perisperm. That is another example. Now, if you want to example, you know, for a small diagram, if it is possible, you can draw technical terms. Either there is another black pen, highlight pen, you know. So, if all of you can know, ectomyces, na na, I am showing you. Polyembryo, na na, I am giving examples. I am showing you. Fruit, na, what are the different type? What is the bathroom type fruits? I am showing you. False fruit, na, na, what is the examples for the false fruit? You have to keep it in mind. Endosperm, write the difference between endospermous and non-endospermous seeds. I mean, so you have to say what is endospermous seeds, where the residual part of the endosperm will remain as such even after the endosperm is being consumed by the embryo, consumed by the zygote for its developmental stages. The residual part of the embryo will be retained inside the seed. Such type of seeds are called as the endospermous seeds. I mean, so no, resinous. And similarly, Coccus lucifera, Tega. அந்த எம்ப்ரியோ எண்டோஸ்போம்ல படிக்கும்போது நம்ம டயகிராம்லாம் போட்டு படிச்சோம் காக்கஸ் லியூசிஃபெரா அப்படினு சொல்லிட்டு அதே மாதிரி காஸ்டர் which is resinous communis. அப்ப நான் எண்டோஸ்போமஸ் னு சொல்லும்போது நான் எண்டோஸ்போமஸ்னா the no residual part of the endosperm will be retained inside the egg. The endosperm will get exhausted. Entire part of the endosperm will be utilized by the zygote and the embryo for its developmental stages appearance for its development for its differentiation morphological differentiation in the embryo and the nutritive tissue எல்லாத்தையுமே will be getting utilized. And the zygote will be getting utilized. Then it is called as what a non-endospermous. Other terms are the ex-albuminous or non-albuminous. I mean, so wrong. The grams and beans are the very best examples. Understand? So fruits are omixes and polyembryony. So almost the lesson is getting over. So do study well. The worksheets will be distributed to you and sit and study. Then it will become very very easy. Doubt clarity class will be there. We will discuss. If you have all, if you have any doubts, you can discuss with me. Understand? நோட்ஸ் என்னென்ன கொடுத்துருக்கோமோ கண்டிப்பாக எழுதி வச்சுக்கோங்க. புக்கில் வந்து தியரிட்டிக்கலாக டிஸ்கிரிப்டிவாக லென்த்தி லென்த்தி பேராகிராஃப்லாம் இருக்கும். ஸோ அதை படிக்கிறதுங்கிறது இட் வில் பிகம் வெரி டீடியஸ் ஸோ நோட்ஸ் மாதிரி சிம்பிளிஃபைடாக நீ எடுத்து வச்சுக்கிட்டேன்னா கண்டினியூட்டி இருந்துகிட்டே இருக்கும். தென் இட் வில் பி வெரி மச் ஹெல்ப்ஃபுல் ஃபார் யூ. த நெக்ஸ்ட் லெசன் ஐ வில் ஸ்டார்ட் வித் ஜெனெடிக்ஸ். ஓகே, தேங்க் யூ.